return to normal, how effective COVID-19 vaccines should be. The recent developments in several COVID-19 vaccine models are good news. But to eradicate the disease, 3/4 or 75% of the population must be vaccinated. Also, the vaccine should be at least 80% effective against SARS-CoV-2, according to a recent study. Currently, the minimum effectiveness is set by the US FDA at 50%. In the study, researchers used a computer simulation to know the minimum vaccine effectiveness to stop the pandemic. But the simulation only refers to vaccination as the sole intervention. The results showed various effectiveness rates based on the coverage of immunization. The reproductive number of COVID-19 has been included as well. If the vaccination coverage is 75%, the vaccine should be 70% effective. This is viable for the R0 of 2.5. If the coverage drops to 60%, the effectiveness must be 80%. This is applicable for the R0 of 3.5. The findings suggest that the least acceptable effectiveness is 60% for vaccination coverage of 100%, while 80% effectiveness for the coverage of 75%. The findings concluded with vaccine effectiveness of between 60% and 80%, higher than the FDA's current requirement. Dr. Bruce Wiley, the study author and professor at City University of New York, wrote in The Conversation, "That doesn't mean a vaccine that offers less protection would be useless, but it would mean social distancing in some form may still be necessary." According to CNBC, a COVID-19 vaccine's effectiveness of 80% for 75% of the population may not be possible at this time. NIAID Director Dr. Anthony Fauci hopes for 75% effectiveness. To compare, the effectiveness of vaccines for seasonal flu plays between 40% and 60%. However, influenza mutates very fast, which makes it difficult to predict the best vaccine formula. The effectiveness is not the only challenge in conquering this pandemic. Many people around the world are unwilling to be vaccinated, especially to a brand new vaccine. This means that 100% coverage is impossible, unless every government made COVID-19 vaccination mandatory. Lee explained that efficacy and effectiveness are two different terms. Efficacy defines performance in controlled settings, like clinical trials, while effectiveness is the performance in the real world. Oftentimes, effectiveness is lower than efficacy. Lee and colleagues published their findings in the American Journal of Preventive Medicine.